Hello everybody and welcome back to Namesworth Farm. It's a bright and early morning to start the big harvest. Now, this is not going to be like hours on end of harvesting. I am going to do all the fields, but some of them will be off screen because I know that some people hate it when I just harvest continually, and I can see why. What we're going to do is we're going to start off with the small fields today, field number 8 and field number 9. Get those done, and then probably tomorrow we'll move on to some bigger fields, and then after that we'll wrap things up and it'll be the big harvest completed. Now I've got the John Deere 6910 with the header trailer here. I have actually changed the header. This is originally the header for the Class Mega, and I've decided to use it on the Tucano because I think it's a better size than the very small 4.9 meter one, I think it is. This one I believe is 6 meters, so this should be a lot better. The only issue is getting it on the header trailer. It's quite a low header. Yeah, it's not too bad. I'm sure you can appreciate that is still quite a small header anyway, so it's not going to be anything stupid. Let's just spin it round, and then we're going to head over to the field. We should probably have the tractor and trailer in front of the combine, actually, because otherwise I can see it now. The worker is going to fling that header across the map, and we'll probably never find it again. So just for the time being, we're driving the John Deere just to the field. After that, we'll be driving the combine. And what a combine it is. Really can't wait to use it properly. Now, the field we're actually going to start off with is the fairly horrific field number 8. And the reason why I call it horrific is because that is the respawn field. So if you ever have to reset a machine, it will appear in the middle of that field. And with crop destruction on, it pretty much eliminates any crops which are there. So it's going to be a very quick job doing that field because there's not really any crops left in there. But it's good just to get it out of the way first of all. It is oilseed rape, I believe, so it's a good crop to start off with. I'm hoping to do the wheat last. The oilseed rape and the barley should be first. The barley isn't totally ripe, so we're going to have to just hold off that for a minute. But the oilseed rape is ready. So we'll kick things off with that. The forecast is for hail in the middle of summer, so I suppose it is possible actually, but yeah, it is on the forecast, so we've got to be a bit wary of that. Just wait for the combine to catch up. There it is. And I think really the best thing to do here is just to drive straight into the field. Actually not looking quite as bad as it was doing now it's fully grown. I haven't seen it since it has grown, but it's a good thing I put this grass border in, otherwise it would be even worse. Right, okay, let's get things kick-started. So yeah, I know that I do quite a bit of harvesting. That is soon going to stop, but for the rest of this map we obviously have to do it, otherwise it's a total waste of our time and efforts with the saw mod. Our efforts should pay off. Perfect. Yeah, I really hope that the attaching in FS17 is improved quite a bit because, yeah, you don't normally just go up to it and then press a button and it goes click. You obviously have to align it perfectly and then get the hooks lined up before you can put the PTO shafts in, and then also lock it in as well. So there are so many things that can be improved. We're just going to have to wait and see, I think, to see what exactly has been changed. But at the time of recording this, it was actually the same day that the Farming Simulator gameplay trailer was released, and it actually looks very good. I do like the look of it a lot. There are similarities with FS15, but you would expect that as it is the next one on, the next installment in the series. But yeah, I think it is brilliant. Can't wait for it. And a few people have said, you sound like you're sponsored. No, not at all. I don't get paid a penny from Giant for doing these videos. I just want to make that clear. They're not sponsored in any way at all. And if they were, I would let you know. Don't worry about it. Okay. The header might be bit too low for the combine. That's weird. That's okay now. Not sure. It's probably just this field, because this field originally wasn't actually an arable field, it was grass, so it could be something to do with that. It's working fine now. And what a good combine it is as well. So this field, the nutrients, is roughly times 5 for the nitrogen and times 2 for the PK. The PK wasn't actually that good, so it's going to let it down a little bit, but on the whole, it's okay. So it should pay off. It's actually not as bad as I thought it was. I thought it was worse than this. It's pretty good. I do like the reversing beep as well. Some of the combines don't have that fitted, but I do like it. Wow, this is sparse, and it's expected as well. All the machines which were ever reset appeared here. There is definitely an issue at the bottom of the field. Don't know what it is. I suppose we could get the Dominator out as well, and it can help us in the big fields. That is actually not a bad idea. If we took the headlands off first of all, and then we get the Takane to go on one side and the Dominator on the other, then we can do the karting, and it'd be really efficient. I think we should do that, but not in this field, obviously. It's just not big enough. Fields such as 20 and 19, I think that would work really well. And as we haven't been using the Fendt tractors too much, we're going to go for one of those. Also, just to update you with Thornton Farm, I said I was looking for a compact tractor. Now, I haven't exactly found a compact tractor, but I found a very small Case. I think it's a Case Maxim, I think. I'm not too familiar with Case, but it looks pretty good. So I think I'm going to go with that. Really decent looking tractor. It's obviously low horsepower, so I suppose you could class it as compact. But if you remember, I think it was episode 2 of this series, that was when I very badly ploughed this field. And, well, you wouldn't have thought it was the same field, really, because when I ploughed it, it looked horrific. And now we have these really profitable crops in here, except for the bottom. All we need to do is get a trailer, because we've got nowhere to tip it. We'll definitely use a Fendt for that though. And our silage burrs over there, they must be nearly ready. We'll have to check on the fermenting stage, see how it's going, and if they're ready, in a few episodes time we'll sell them. This is the final part of this field. That was very quick. So, well, it was expected. It's such a small field. Field number 9, however, is considerably larger. So that is going to be a better field to do. There we go. So, I've just had some bad news, actually. One of the fields has withered. And I'm amazed it withered so quickly, because last time I looked at it, it had a few growth stages left. Soil mod must have updated during the night, and that is the reason why it's withered. So that is not too good. We've got a bit of a loss there. But as I said before, we're going to win and lose some. But in real life, that'd be really costly. But it is my first time of using soil mod, so I guess I have a bit of an excuse, but nothing really. That is really bad news. It's field number 10. Right. This tractor is going to be washed straight away. And then we're going to put it on the Marshall trailer. I think the Stewart trailer is just not really the best one for the job. Right. It should be in there. And I did say we were going to harvest these crops in the correct order. However, I'm a bit worried about field number 9 now, because obviously that was planted quite a long time ago. And there is the potential for it to wither as well. So I think really we're going to have to get that done. Otherwise we could have another withered field, which I really do not want. Wow. That is pretty terrible. That was really bad, because I put so much work into that, and just because I didn't check it frequently enough, it's withered. But luckily, it is only a game. It's not real life. But that just shows that I wouldn't be a very good farm manager. I don't know. I think it's probably harder in Farming Simulator though, because you have to, well, it's hard to plant all the fields together, because you always want to harvest another one. So they're all at different stages. Obviously you don't have to worry so much about the different types of chemicals in Farming Simulator. That would be a lot harder in real life. But stuff like that would be, I think, easier. Don't even know where that barley came from. It was just in the trailer. Well, I think field number 9 can be the field where we use two combines, because I want to get that in as quickly as possible. At least we've got the we've got one field in so far. I wonder if we can go on the road with the header on without crashing. It is quite a big header, so that's going to be quite difficult. I think to play it safe, we're going to have to put the header back on the trailer. Otherwise, we're going to be taking out all the trees. There we go. And we'll head over there. Then we'll get the traction trailer taken there, along with the other combine. It is such a narrow gateway. But this is the field right here. Yeah, it feels such a long time ago we did this. It's going to wither if we leave it. And the header. After this though, there will be no more harvesting to do at all. This will be it. We should be able to begin once again. I don't know if we're going to bale it. I really don't think we should do, because it's quite a tight field. Yeah, I think for this field we'll leave it. I hate seeing that field. That field is so bad. I can't believe it's happened, because I was trying to be careful, but clearly that wasn't enough. That is one thing about the withering. I think the issue with it is, well, I'm not trying to make excuses, because obviously I've made a big mistake there. But one thing is that if you've got withering switched on, it kind of goes from fully ripe to totally withered instantly. So you don't really see, unless you're looking at the map, that it's about to wither. You should see it probably start to wilt or something, or maybe go greyer over time. But I think the transition is a bit too sudden. But I don't know. I really don't know. It was just a big mistake on my part. So you live and learn. It's just one of those things, I think. But one thing's for sure. I think one thing that's turned out quite well is the tramlines. You can't really see them. You can see like a faint line where they are, as you would do in real life. But nothing like really destructive. And I think that is because in this field we used the row crop tyres, I think we did. And it does make a massive difference. Looking at it, this field is actually quite small. So having another combine in here, by the time we've got the headlands removed, it probably wouldn't even be worth it. But we will be using the Dominator, definitely, in the big fields, field 19 and 20. I've just noticed something, and it's incredible. You can actually see on the reel of the combine, you can see some of the pieces of straw going over the top. Never noticed that before. That looks so amazing. They're not all going through. I don't remember seeing that before on the Mega. It's incredible. Just kneading up this side here. And then we can do another headland. Just taking the oilseed rape to the sell point because we only have like 27%. There's no point putting this into storage. We've literally condensed all the field number 8 into 27% of this field. But that is understandable. Two reasons, one because it was so bad in the first place, and also because it is oilseed rape, so you get less per hectare than you do with wheat or barley. Get it unloaded. You can already see how profitable this field is. The PK is much better. It's times 2. Still not amazing, but it's a lot better. And the nutrients is times 5. And obviously no weeds at all. So I think this field is actually pretty good. Tramline here. I think that is probably the sparsest it gets. All the others are pretty good, that's where I've overlapped. See, I continue around there, but it's not really that noticeable. And we're 50% again, so when we get back up to the trailer, I think we'll empty. Okay, let's just unload. We're not full, but if I unload this time, then we don't run the risk of overflowing, and also we can totally go round again, twice probably, without being full again. So just fill up the trailer. I should think this is happening quite a lot in the UK at the moment, in fact anywhere. Go. Let's resume. Yeah, we're now at that stage where I technically could get the other harvester, but would it really be worth it? Because you've only got like this strip in the middle. I suppose you could do it. But we're going to leave that for a bigger field. And there we go, we're almost full once again. So we're going to have to unload the trailer, come back again, unload the combine probably twice more. And that'll be us done for today. Like I say, I'm going to do some off screen. So probably field number, possibly one of 19 or 20 will be done off screen. And then field number 1, which is the one we did the other day, we'll definitely be doing that on screen. But there we go, let's just park it here, because we are virtually full. We actually could top up the trailer slightly more, So we'll do that just to ensure we can fit the rest in. And this is going to be going over to the storage yard. I'm not totally sure where the storage place for the wheat is, so we're going to have to look for it. But I can't imagine it's too far away from the barley. Is it just here on the left? I think it is. Yeah, it's looking promising. So if we just reverse it straight into there. Mind the caravan. And straight back to the combine. Just a small amount left to do. I think really we've done pretty well. Except for that field, of course. Oh, that field, I can't stop thinking about it. It's only a field that's not even real, but the amount of work that was put into it, that's what's disappointing. We even have more storage space as well for the Tucano, because we've got the shed which we put up over there. That is a perfect place for it. So I think when the harvest is over, that'll be where it goes. And if Navesmo Extended looks similar to this area, obviously I've only seen the screenshots, then we'll obviously place that straight back in again for the next series. This is it, the final section of the field. The Tucano has coped and managed this field very well, as you would expect from a new combine. No downtime at all. But I do like the Lexion pack a lot better. I'm not got anything bad about this mod. It's a very good mod, but the fact that the Lexion mod allows you to unblock it. If you go too fast through a dense crop, it'll actually block up, and I like that kind of thing. You can technically have downtime, as you would do in real life. But here we go. We are done. So, that is it for today. We'll obviously be leaving the other fields until tomorrow. Some of them aren't even ready yet, but obviously we had to prioritise this one because it's been so long since we planted it. But yeah, that is it. So, except for the disappointing field number 10, hopefully you've enjoyed the video, and we will return tomorrow for more on Naveswell Farm. Until then, thank you for watching, and hope to see you again in the next video. Hopefully things will go a bit smoother. See you again soon. Bye for now.